Here to celebrate Sid's 50th birthday. Thank you to our favorite band. Thank you to our out-of-town guests. We have my brother-in-law, I can't say anything, but my brother-in-law, Jay Regalado, is here from New York City a couple nights ago. We have a few of Sid's best friends from high school in town. I can't see them, but we have Sachin Kumar drove in from Michigan. Andres McDonald was supposed to drive in from Michigan if he's here. Okay, he's not on the best friend list anymore. Andy Wang drove in from the western suburbs. Yes, I did, and I wrote out a speech. So I'll refer to it if I need to, but I thought about it. I thought about a family talk we had a couple weeks ago. We were just talking about midlife and reassessing what's important to us. Besides, you know, work and school and the daily routine. And of course, we talked about making the time to spend time not only with family, but with friends. And making time to really spend time doing things that light us up. Because not everyone has that, but you have to figure that out. And I feel like Sid, you've always lived your life this way. Like Sid has, he has a love for life. He, to be honest, he's the one who planned this party. Woo! That's the truth. And he just wanted to have all his people in one place, and he wanted to just see people having fun. So that's, thank you for just having fun. I'll tell you just one little story. Like, I remember someone asking Sid, I was kind of overhearing a conversation, asking, oh, what's the best concert you ever went to? And I was like, oh, he's going to talk about Britney Spears or Madonna.
Four times Britney Spears.
Instead, he's like, he started telling about this time he took me to the Chicago Theater to see the Lumineers when they were just starting out. And he said that was his favorite concert. I was like, he did not know that band, he didn't know any of the songs, but he just had such joy seeing me have fun. And that's like, he seriously just wants to see his people having fun. So I do love it about you, Sid. But he does have his hobbies, and he has his Sid hobbies, which are obsessions. So about 16 years ago, he was really into photography. It was a beautiful thing. I mean, until we ended up with a closet full of really, really expensive cameras with like these super long lenses, and it got to the point where I stopped counting. They were so expensive, but he was taking beautiful photos of all our kids, and I thought, this is lovely. But then it morphed into beautiful photos of insects. So he would go into our garden. We don't really have a garden. So he'd go into our lawn and collect insects, a lot of flies, honestly. And then he would collect them in like mason jars and put them in my freezer to stun them so that they would be more sedated for the photo shoot. And they were beautiful photos. They really were. This landed him a gig he was offered a gig as the variety show photographer. It was a volunteer position, but he was very proud, and that became his new obsession. fashion. It was soon after that, like the next year, he is like GoPro on head. He is practicing singing in the bathroom, and he's dancing and singing and acting on stage, and that became his new hobby, his obsession. I mean, he fell in love. I think it was by the next year, maybe 2 years after that, he was producing the whole show with Michael Park as the director. So he really put his heart and soul into that. It was lovely. 10 years ago, he started Googling or YouTubing how to make wooden furniture. Then he moved our cars out of the garage, and he converted our garage into a workspace. That means like the whole thing, like the saw, he had everything. And he did not emerge until there were at least like 20 pieces of beautiful wooden furniture that came out of that. He furnished our whole patio in the backyard. He made bar stools. He made me a coffee table. He made our kids' desks. He made Samantha a loft per request. He then made, or actually the first thing he made this like rolling cart for a cooler. Then he made a rolling cart for an outdoor TV stand. That sounds more like Sid. So let's see, what else? I think it was about six years ago, there was the softball obsession that continues. No mercy. All I will say about that is I thought it was a friendly neighborhood, family-oriented thing I was in.
Hello, 2019 champs.
I was going to say that. Let me finish my story, because suddenly he's like, no, I'm going to make my own team. He started scouting people. He started recruiting people. He started asking me to try out. I literally had to ask one of my sons to help me like learn how to throw. I kind of tried out, and I got cut. I was not the only one. But with that said, yes, 2019, no mercy, woo! Champion. Yes. So I'll say, when he told me he wanted his motorcycle license, I should have known he was not kidding. He got the license. We didn't see him for a while. He was always, you know, getting the license. And then, again, I lost half of my garage. He moved his car onto the street, and within a few years, we had 3 motorcycles in that spot, which made it very hard for me to get into my spot. And I'm like, why 3, you ask? But apparently you need like a different motorcycle for different occasions. And some people may understand that, Steve Malfa, maybe. He recently just brought home a mint green Vespa scooter for his, like, so he can look cute biking to Starbucks. So, you know, all kidding aside, I know, Sid, that it brings you great joy to be out on the road, in the, you know, driving through the farmlands with Steve, or just alone most of the time, just listening to his podcast or to his like 80s mix. And you know what? I think it's awesome. I give you a hard time, but I think it's really awesome. So I think continue to, you know, bring it for your friends and family, bring people together, and continue like spending time doing the things that light you up. Happy birthday, Sid. Thank you for being here.
Hello.
Hi, Sid.
Thank you. You know, thank you to everybody for coming here on this road trip tonight. Out of our safe zone of Womack. To be honest, I don't do well in these group settings because I tend to stay out on the dance floor. I don't do a good job of mingling and talking to people
So I decided that I was going to talk a little bit longer than most people wanted or expected tonight, just so that everybody felt like they had a deep conversation with me tonight. One-sided, but a deep conversation. And I'm going to talk about growing older. So a lot of people dread the idea of turning 50. I love turning 50. 50 is the sweet spot, right? You're not young and naive. You're not antique or ancient. You're perfectly vintage. And everybody loves things that are vintage. You know, you're soft, you have some imperfections, maybe scratched a little bit, but you're dependable, reliable, you stood the test of time, people respect you. People love vintage things because they're charming, endearing, and very attractive. So you're probably wondering how I became so charming, endearing, and attractive. It wasn't easy. I have a lot of people to thank. My parents were obviously a big influence on me. Unfortunately, my parents could not be here with us tonight. Don't worry, they're still alive. They just live in Las Vegas and they don't like to fly. In my 20s, my brother and my high school boys, big influences on me. A lot of great memories, a lot of great embarrassing stories. That is why they are not speaking tonight. My 30s, I think about getting married, moving, having kids, moving to Wilmette. It was a great time. I met my lovely wife, Christina. And she loves me back 100% of the time. We have three wonderful kids, Brandon, Marcus, and Samantha, who I love unconditionally, and they love me back 50% of the time. 48% of the time, I'm just so annoying. And then 2% of the time, they just ask me to fix the Wi-Fi. My 40s, like she alluded to, I think about my midlife crises. I had a few, they aren't too bad. We're talking motorcycles, co-ed softball, and the variety show. These are three things that I kind of stumbled upon them, but they became very passionate to me. I dove all in, don't regret any of that. Now that I've turned the corner to 50, we'll see what this next decade brings. Pickleball, perhaps? We'll see. But this vintage form of Sydney is not done. I'm still ready to put some shine, some add to the patina of what I've done so far. I've lived my best life so far, and I have all of you here to thank. So thank you. So I'm going to give some advice to all you youngins out there, and whippersnappers, Gen Zers like my brother. And I think our dear friend Erica would agree with me. You shouldn't wait until you turn 50 to start living your best life. You should be living your best life now. You should have been living your best life weeks ago. Our dear friend Erica reminded us, just so I get it correct, you never know what the future holds, so don't wait for something to happen. Live your life. Live it the best you can. Say yes more often. Go outside of your comfort zone. Take the trip. Learn the dance. Eat the donut. Buy that fourth motorcycle. I've been lucky to, I started living my best life about 24 years ago when I met my wife, Christina.
Yeah.
We started out as friends, and then she started aggressively pursuing me shortly afterwards. I was definitely pre-vintage at that time. But you never get to the best form of yourself, this vintage form of yourself, without meeting that perfect person, the person that brings the best out of you. We've had many years of laughter and love together, sometimes simultaneously. I'm so lucky to have found you as my person. Thank you. I love you. I look forward to becoming antique and ancient with you. And to everyone else out here, I love all of you too. Again, I'm bad at circulating. I'm gonna be out on the dance floor the rest of the night. I'll be the one dancing, jumping around. Screaming the wrong lyrics out of tune. That'll be me. Come join me on the dance floor. Thank you for coming. And I love you all. Thank you.
One more thing. It would not be a Sid birthday party without a Sid birthday serenade. So please pay attention to the lyrics and sing along.
Sing along, everybody! Thank you!
Cheers to you.